Hello everyone, in this video tutorial, I am going to explain parallelogram law of forces. The law of parallelogram of forces states that if two forces acting on a particle, in this case I take an P and Q, at the same time, if it is represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of the parallelogram, drawn from the same point, the resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram drawn from the same point. The law is very simple. If two forces are acting from a particle, in this case I taken it as O. At the same time, if these two forces are represent two sides of a parallelogram, if I want the resultant of these two forces, I have to find the diagonal of this that parallelogram. To prove this law, I will complete this figure like this. I will represent the diagonal as a resultant. So I will draw the diagonal of this parallelogram like this. So which will be the resultant of these two forces? To prove this, I will take like this. So I will complete this rectangle. I will take this as A, this as B, then this as C. I will produce OA along AC, then I will draw BC perpendicular to AC. So from the triangle OBC, if I apply the Pythagoras theorem, I can write OB square is equal to OC square plus BC square. OB is the hypotenuse, OC square plus BC square. So where OB is nothing but resultant, I can write like this, R square is equal to OC, I can write OA plus AC whole square, then R square is equal to OA is nothing but P plus AC plus BC square, where AC and BC are two unknowns. So I have to find those things. For that, I will use the triangle ABC. So the angle between two forces, I will take it as theta. So if this is theta, I can take this is also theta, because OD and AB are parallel to each other. If these two are things are parallel, if I draw one line, this is theta also, this I can write it as theta. Now from triangle ABC, I can take cos theta is equal to adjacent is AC, hypotenuse is AB. So unknown is AC. So if I want AC, I can write AB cos theta. Therefore AC is equal to AB is nothing but Q. So I can write Q cos theta. At the same time, I can take sin theta in the same triangle ABC opposite, that is BC divided by AB. So I want BC here, therefore BC is equal to AB sin theta, therefore BC is equal to AB is nothing but Q sin theta. So I will take this as equation 1. I will substitute these values in equation 1. So I can write R square is equal to P AC is nothing but Q cos theta whole square plus BC is Q sin theta whole square. So R square is equal to A plus B whole square, that is A square plus Q square cos square theta, that is B square, plus 2PQ cos theta plus Q square sin square theta. So R square is equal to P square plus, I will take Q square common from these two, therefore Q square is equal to sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2PQ cos theta. So I can write this as 1, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore R is equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta, root of this answer. So in parallelogram law of force, if you want to find the value of R, that is resultant, you can use this formula, that is Q square plus P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So if I want to find the resultant angle of the resultant, so I will take this as alpha. So I can take tan alpha in the triangle OBC. Tan alpha is equal to BC divided by OC. So tan alpha is equal to BC divided by OA plus AC. So just I will substitute tan alpha is equal to BC, already we calculated, it is Q sin theta divided by OA. OA is P plus AC, that is Q cos theta. So if I do the inverse of this, I will get the angle of the resultant.